Okay, because we have two spines, I'm going to call it left page one and right page one. We've already done the left page one, and the right one is going to fall. Let me get my papers out here. It's going to fall when it's open. It'll fall right underneath it like that. Do not make your pages any larger than this one, because let me show you what I discovered. And this is okay, but we certainly don't want to run into problems because we've made them too big. Okay, now this is the page here. This is the page we've made, and we don't have anything else in there, so it doesn't want to stay. But see, it just fits in there nicely with a little bit of movement here. So don't make your pages any larger than that. And the next one is going to go right underneath there then. So let's open it up. We are on the right first hinge. And I have taken a piece of red. This red is 6.5 by 7.5. I've corner rounded the edges with a 1/2 inch corner rounder. I cut a mat. And remember, it's going to be right under here. So we want this to follow through now, because this is what visually your eye is going to see when it opens. So I cut the mat with the Santa Clauses, and the mat is, I don't know, did I not write down what the mat was? The mat is 1/4 inch. It must be 6.25 by 7.25, because it's just a little bit smaller. And that's going to go on there. Let's glue it on, because that's done. You don't have to do it this way. You can do it any way you want to. This is the way I do it, so that I know that everything is going to flow together as the book is open, because that's the whole key. And I'm just loving the way this, you can't see it over here, but the way this belly band is looking, super cool. Okay, I just corner rounded with a 1/2 inch corner rounder the outer edges to the left, because the other is going to attach right to the book, and we're going to do that next. Just press that really down all the way around, and my baby wipe has dried out a little bit, so I'm just going to add some water on it so I can make sure my glue stays good. So this is the first one in my end frame. First one on the right, the top. Ooh, we have some lifting here. Let's put some glue on that and get that back down where it's supposed to be. Okay. And then I will show you what I did. I had made some Christmas cards with this collection, and I had some pieces left over from it, and that, oops, okay, now, this key is, we want to make sure we're lining up the top and the bottom, and we do not want to go over where our hinge is, so that our page will have good mobility. It will go back and forth. And the only way it does that is by making sure that you're on the other side of your score mark here where your hinge is. There we go. Very good. Press it down super, super tight. As we get our other pages in, they kind of take care of themselves because they're glued. They have so much more stability because they're glued to one another. I don't know why this page wants to keep lifting, but we're going to glue that sucker down so it never comes apart. Okay, so let's get the glue out of the way, and let me show you what I did. All right, there's this page right here, and I had used this Santa Claus in the sleigh. I had cut it out, so I had this frame. So I cut the rest of the frame really nice and quarter rounded the edges with a 1/4 inch quarter rounder. And then I added a mat. Did I put down what the mat was? The mat is 6.25 by 4.25, but it's just enough that it completely covers it. Now I have score tape on all four sides. I'm only removing the score tape from the bottom and the left-hand side. And let's put it over here so you can see. Now hopefully I'm going to place this so it's pretty well centered with a nice red border all the way around. Now, if you noticed what I said, I have score tape on these two edges, but I'm not going to glue them down because whoever gets this book, when they put their picture in here, what do I have? What do I have? What do I have? Oh, come on. I must have something here. Okay. When I put the picture of Santa Claus in here, let's just, oh, here's one. When I put the picture of Santa Claus in here, and I got him all in where I want him, then I can take the tape off of these two and secure it down. But until that time, I want to have it as easy as possible to put it in the frame. And boy, is my frame off. I guess it's not as bad as I think. Okay, now I'm going to put it on the angle. I want him to look like this. I don't want it flush down. Now, again, you can do it on three sides and leave room for a pocket on the edge. I'm going to do that again. I have no idea if I'm actually ever going to use that pocket, but maybe you have secret things you want to say about your Christmas, memories that you want to tuck in, but you don't want the whole world to see. Well, you'd have a great hiding spot right underneath here, right in there, right in here, that nobody would know about, that you could write down journaling things to keep forever. Okay, now, when we have our book, when we open our book, this is what we're going to see. We're going to see on the left side our waterfall. Oh, our waterfall. We're going to see our first page, and then we're going to see this page. See, it's still all tying together here. We're going to do another waterfall on this side that will mirror this one, that will flip this way. So it's coming together. What do you think? I think this is a fun book. And when it closes, then this comes up like that, and it all closes neatly into its own little case. There we go. So page one on the right, now done. Be back in a shortly. After I said that about having the little journaling spot there, I got to playing after I got off camera. So this is just a little add-on. I took this piece of craft. It is 4 3/4 by 4 inches. And I have this Stampin' Up! Label punch. And I know you can't get it anymore, but you can use the cloud if you have this on two sides like that and put a hole in the middle. Anyway, I use that label punch. And I punched it out on a 2 inch by 2 inch piece, put the no peeking from the elements pieces on from the collection. And then I took and I made a slit right here and put it to the inside, and I glued it down here and here. So it's kind of coming out of it. Great pull tab. I did the lines with this hot off the press journaling spot with these things down here and the red festive berry ink from distressing from Tim Holtz that I've been using. That way I have a journaling spot. I matted the back with the marshmallow thing, put some of the crunched seam binding on it, and now look how cute this looks. Let me move my stuff out of the way. And you tuck this back behind, and you have a nice place for journaling. It just really added to this page. And that's the thing. Little things like this are what really make it. And it's kind of a surprise there. You don't see it when your book is closed and as it opens and like this. Then when you flip it open, you say, oh, gee, looky here. Another little element surprise. So I just wanted to show you that before I moved on. Okay, on to the next page.